want to start off by saying, yes, I know what was going on with Paris and their bassist Alex Babinski. They have parted ways due to allegations of him being a little too friendly with some of his younger fans. However, those are only accusations right now. We'll let that play out. They're letting him, you know, obviously defend himself as he's taking these people to court to defend his innocence, whereas these other girls are, I guess, coming out and saying that he did this and he DM'd me this. But until there's actual breathtaking proof of either one, then we just gotta really think about it and just realize that right now, it's accusations, someone's lying, someone's telling the truth, and that's how that's gonna end. Even if he comes out, if it comes out and he never did this before, I don't think he'll be back in Paris. This was just a precautionary thing before this album came out, which that just so happened to be 2 days before this album came out. But now here we are, the new, brand new, third studio album by the rock band Paris is here. Use Me. This is their long-awaited follow-up to their sophomore effort, All We Know of Heaven, All We Need of Hell. They have a 3-year period in between each album, so I guess it really wasn't long-awaited. It was kind of more like on time. However, this thing was supposed to come out in May. It got delayed multiple times, but now we definitely have it today, and it's 11 songs long, and some of these I heard before, because some of these were on the Hallucinations EP last year, so there was just more of like maybe like 6 or 7 new songs on here that I didn't hear before. Let's just start off with some of my least favorite. Stay Gold and January Rain to me just didn't do much, as did the title track itself, which does feature 070 Shake. I don't know, those were like the weak efforts on this song. These were more of like the actual generic pop that everybody said that they were doing with other songs. Like, these are the generic ones. The other songs don't even come close to being generic, but these ones were just very boring and that weren't that enjoyable. In the okay tracks, we have Good to Be Alive and Old Wounds. This was one of the ones that came off the Hallucinations EP. It wasn't one of my favorites. I think it was actually one of my least favorites off the EP, but on the album, it just becomes an okay track for me, because listening to it again and hearing all the other songs that were on the album, I go, you know, it's definitely better than the 3 worst in my opinion, and this is also one of the better Lin Gun vocal moments on the entire album, so I'll give them credit where it's due with that one. And that leaves the rest of the album basically being my favorite. I loved Give Me a Minute when it came out. That was just a party bop. We have Dead Weight, which was another one. This was the, like, I guess you can say second single that came out from this. Like I said, there was 3 songs from the Hallucinations EP that ended up here, so that is what it is. But yeah, Dead Weight was on here. Death of Me and Hallucinations, which those were the last 2 from that EP to appear on this album. Death of Me was my favorite over Hallucinations at first, but Hallucinations has really grown on me and become a bop. I especially love the music video, where you get kind of like this, it's like you just like took psychedelic mushrooms and are just tripping really, really hard. But the song overall, very catchy. We have Loveless, Wish You Well as the last 2 favorites. These are just the songs that hit hard, hit very well, and are very memorable, and, you know, just do their thing as to what they're supposed to do. I mean, it took a while. It really did take a while for me to find a song where I'm like, this isn't really my favorite. And when an album goes that long before doing so, you know that you are in for a nice ride, because you just keep on finding stuff that you enjoy, finding stuff that you like. And with Paris, I don't want to say this, their first 2 albums are still very, very good, but people also have to realize that it's not like they haven't tackled sounds like this before. If you've heard their first 2 albums, you would know that yes, they did have a lot of pop rock tracks on there, but they also tackled a little bit more of like a pop type sound. This is another one of those bands, as I had mentioned in my video, Genreless Music is the New Norm. This could potentially be on the list of one of the bands that's just genreless. We don't know where to put them, because early on, before Lin Gun, this was a hardcore. I love the talent in this band and the fact that they're willing to expand their sound a little bit more, even if it means the fans are gonna get pissed off. Slap on me now. Overall, very enjoyable album. Didn't see myself, like, wanting to turn it off a lot. There's been a lot of albums this year where, like, less than halfway through, I'm just like, I'm done. I don't want to listen to this thing anymore. But with this album, even the worst moments still didn't make me fully, like, cringe or anything. There may have just been something missing from some of those songs, and it didn't have what the other songs had in this case. So I think, overall, 7.5 out of 10 is pretty decent for this album. They have 3 albums out, 3 very good records that I would definitely go back and listen to more often than not. This is still probably, in my opinion, their worst record, but that doesn't say much considering it's still very good at this point. But yeah, that basically does it for my review of this. You can tell me in the comments below, what did you think of this album? Did you like it? Did you hate it? And yeah, I mean, until then, stay safe out there, and I will catch you all in the next one.